The hidden DNA of the Jomon, tracing Japan's ancient D lineage. Hello, everyone. Today we'll uncover a fascinating story hidden in our DNA, one that rewrites what we thought we knew about the origins of the Japanese people. What if I told you that Japanese DNA is significantly different from that of neighboring Asian countries? The key lies in a rare Y-chromosome haplogroup known as D. Let's start with the basics. Humans have sex chromosomes, X and Y. Mothers can only pass on the X chromosome, but fathers can pass on either X or Y. This means your biological sex, double X for female, XY for male, is determined by your father's contribution. Here's the important part. The Y chromosome is only passed down through the male line, so scientists can use it to trace our paternal ancestry, generation after generation. Thanks to advancements in genetic research, we've now classified humanity into about 20 major Y-DNA haplogroups. In Japan, it's dominated by one of the rarest, haplogroup D. Most East Asian populations, Chinese, Koreans, Southeast Asians, belong to haplogroup O. But in Japan, D is surprisingly prevalent. And not just any D, it's a highly unique subgroup called D1A2A, formerly D1B, which is found only in Japan. So where did this mysterious D lineage come from? Surprisingly, similar D haplogroups have been found in two ethnic groups in southern China, the Qiang and the Yi people. The Qiang have about 4% D1A1, and the Yi have as much as 16%. Now here's where it gets wild. According to Chinese legends, the Qiang people are descended from the mythical emperor Shenong, a figure closely tied to the legendary Yellow Emperor and even the first An Emperor. Some historical accounts also link this lineage to Xu Fu, a Qin Dynasty alchemist who was said to have sailed to Japan. Even more intriguing, an Israeli genetic research group, Ami Shav, has proposed that the Qiang people may be descendants of the tribe of Manasseh, one of the lost tribes of Israel. Yes, you heard that right. Xu Fu might have been part of this ancient lineage, bringing with him the blood of a lost tribe that eventually mingled with the people of Japan. It gets deeper. According to Chinese myth, a warrior named Qiyu, a descendant of Shenong, was defeated and his people scattered. These scattered groups may have become the Qiang and Yi peoples, and this is where the genetic thread ties back to Japan. The D1A2A lineage of the ancient Jomon people in Japan may be directly connected to these groups, suggesting that they all share a common ancestor. In other words, some ancient seafaring people may have once left Japan, voyaged across the world, and eventually returned. Some settled in China, becoming the ancestors of the Qiang and Yi. Others stayed in Japan, preserving the D1A2A haplogroup. Supporting this theory is the fact that the Yi people are linked to the ancient Yangtze River civilization, one of the earliest creators of pottery in the world. And here's something curious. In the past, the Yi people were also referred to as the Wa people, a name that echoes the early Japanese name Wa for themselves. It seems unlikely such a name would arise in China unless the people themselves had strong ties to Japan. So through haplogroup D, we glimpse a massive ancient movement of people, unrecorded by history, but preserved in our genes. Now let's talk about diversity. Japan has extremely high Y-DNA diversity compared to other Asian countries. Why? Because Japan never experienced the kind of brutal male genocide that came with foreign invasions in other parts of the world. In many regions, invaders would wipe out local men, replacing the Y chromosome line with their own. But in Japan, for over 10,000 years, the people lived relatively peacefully, intermingling with newcomers rather than destroying them. As a result, ancient haplogroups like D have survived and evolved right up to the modern day. But the Jomon weren't just peaceful, they were advanced. They developed one of the world's earliest seafaring cultures and made beautiful pottery, all while living in harmony with nature. In a way, they were the original high consciousness civilization. Of course, Jomon life wasn't perfect. Life was short, harsh, and filled with natural dangers. We shouldn't romanticize the past, but we can learn from it. Maybe what we need to carry forward from the Jomon isn't their way of life, but their spirit. Thanks for joining this journey through time and DNA. If you enjoyed this, please like, share, and subscribe. More epic stories from ancient Japan are coming soon.